I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
Mr. D, do you follow MMA at all?
Yeah, I follow a little bit. I'll tell you, that's brutal.
Who do you like in
MMA? That's brutal. I just want to say it's brutal. I mean, brutal good. The guys are intense. I have so much respect for all the guys, you know, because they intense, you know.
What do you think of that? Nate Diaz, Nick Diaz, Conor McGregor, Khabib?
Well, I just like to... I like how the guys prepare themselves, the hunger that they have. You know, then they get in there, they put on a good show. You know, that's what it's about. They go in, and it's a respect of the game. That's what I like.
How would Mr. T do in MMA given the boxing, wrestling, and jiu-jitsu Muay Thai?
See, that's the wrong thing to say. Remember, I'm 66. I had my day. I am content with my life. I'm not trying to prove nothing to nobody. You'll never see me back in wrestling, never see me back this and that. I am honored. All I ever wanted to do, here's who I am for the world to know. Here's who I am in a nutshell. Take away the gold, take away the mohawk, take away this here. I'm just a poor black kid who grew up, had a goal in life, who loved his mother. You know, my mother taught me to pray, taught me to be considered less fortunate. All I ever wanted to do in my life was to grow up, be responsible, be a good son to my mother. I said I was gonna buy a house and pretty dresses. That's who I am. They can say anything else, that's all I want to do in my life, and I done that. After Rocky III, I bought my mother. I take food to the homeless and stuff like that. I don't make a big fuss about it. So I'm not back in the fight. I enjoy a good athlete, how he go through his round to get ready, prepare himself. I like that, but you'll never see me in the ring again or like that. I'm content with who I am.
What was it like being around Muhammad Ali as his bodyguard?
It was the greatest. It was great. It was a dream come true because I couldn't believe it. I used to dream of this guy. I used to watch all his fight. Frazier, I watched when he came from the Olympics. I remember what he said when he came back from the Olympics in Louisville and the guys called him a nigger. Then he said, this here gold medal ain't worth nothing. He threw it in the river. You know, then he told me why he changed his name to Muhammad from Cassius Clay. Everything about him. And then he said, my body is a temple. You know, I gotta keep it ready. And I used to exercise and be ready and all that. So he was my hero come to life. Like I said, I get a chance. He came to my high school when I was a wrestling champ in high school. Then we meet up again. I'm bodyguard him. Then we meet up again in Rocky III. His house is Rocky's house in the movie. Man, my life is complete. I'm blessed. So I was taught that the blessed of us must try to save the less of us. So that's what my success means to me, that I can give back and help other kids and tell them they don't have to grow up to be bad. They don't have to rob nobody. They don't have to break in nobody's house, you know. So maybe everybody won't get it, but maybe one or two kids will. And that's what it's all about. That's who I am in a nutshell.
Unfortunately, this past weekend, 60 people were shot in Chicago.
In Chicago, I know that. I saw that. Eight or 10 dead, you know. And I'll be around there. I try to talk. You know, but you only can do so much. Maybe I try to say the younger kids, but it's the older kids that shoot the younger kids. So it's sad, but I say, not trying to force other old people, we got to get back to God. And that's the problem. That's the problem. They have left God, so when you leave God, you have no structure. You have no foundation. See, I know if I wasn't with God, you'd be reading about all kind of crazy stuff on me. Because the paparazzi followed me 24 hours. They rent a house right next door to me.
You're serious?
I want to get something on me. But that's okay, because when you stand on the word of God telling kids don't do bad and whatever, so they say, let's look for the chink in his armor because we know he ain't that good. Truthfully, I'm not that good. That's why I believe in God. I ask God to protect me and guide me. Because if I didn't have God, I'd be going off on everybody. You say, he bought me the team, pop that guy, hit that guy, drugs and car wrecks and all that. But because of God, because this is what my mother wanted me to have. She says, no, son, forgive. Let things go. I'm nothing but a big, overgrown, tough mama's boy. That's all I am. Believe in God.
Have you seen the movie Creed? Creed 2's
coming
out.
Oh, yes, yes, yes.
What did you think?
I like it. It's good. It's good. It's good. It's good. It's good.
Rocky's aging. He's
right. No, Rocky is the best. He created it. I got a chance to know when we did the movie. He would tell me stuff, you know, what it meant when he started off, came here to Hollywood, didn't have an agent or whatever. Nobody wanted to touch him. He said, I got a dream. And the guy said, okay, I'll give you $250,000 for that script, but I don't want you in it. He said, I'll burn it first. See, he could have said, ooh, $250,000. I'll take that money. He wouldn't be where he is now. He had to believe that he was Rocky. So every kid got to believe they can get out together. You can believe you're important. You are somebody. You can make it. And that's what I try to do.
When you were in Rocky III, did you think it would become such a cult movie that everyone around the world knows it?
No, I never thought of it. Only thing I thought, I said, I just want to do a good job at Rocky because he took a chance with me. He believed in me because during the bouncer contest, he was at home. He was flicking the channel. He saw me. He said, that guy's different and he can talk. So he had the casting director to call the show Don Omar production to get my name and everything. Then they sent it out and they said, wow, lady called me. She said, do you know Rocky? I said, I know Rocky. I've seen Rocky 1 and 2. And she said, he's interested in putting you in Rocky 3. I said, wow, I'm honored. So he sent me this script and stuff like that. So I am honored that he gave me opportunity. So I just want to do good for him because I told him. I said, for whatever reason you pick me, I'm going to give you 110% every day. You know what he said? I know you will, T. I know you will. So I didn't want to let him down.
And you didn't?
Definitely.
Now,
definitely.
If you had to put Amir Khan in a movie, what would be the name of the movie?
It'll be,
Amir.
The name of the movie?
Yes, the name of a movie with Amir Khan in it. Boxing movie. His nickname is Amir King Khan.
King Khan, wag. Dude, let me see. Anyway, I'm about to work on that, but I'll tell you one thing. It'll be a good movie, I'll tell you that much. And it'll be G-rated, so all the kids can come.
That's right.
Won't be no cursing, won't be no sex scenes, won't be all that stuff. You see the brother running. You see him at the mosque praying to his God. You see what I mean? People need to see that. See, I respect everybody.
He goes every Friday.
Huh?
He's very devoted.
That's what he got to be. Ali used to pray. That's why, even though I was a Christian, when Ali would go in the corner and pray, do the Muslim prayer, man, that was powerful. That was powerful. That was about every man. You got to have a God to believe in.
Why did he change his name to Muhammad Ali? Why didn't he pick a different name? Why?
The Muslim gave him that name, you know, because, you know, he had, this is like saying, going from nothing to something, you know. So he had to wash off the old name, as he called it, the white man name, Cassius Clay, the slave name, you know, because great slave master had a name, so they give it to their slaves and whatever. He said, no, I got to be free from that. So he changed his name, you know.
And now he's the most famous name in the history of the world.
Well, not just famous. He's more than that. People mix that with what he did, what he represented. You know, he gave hope to us. He helped to the kid. He didn't tell a black kid to go out there and steal. He said, no, clean your act up. Be good in school. Listen to your parents. That's my message. I tell the same kids that what my mother taught me, be good. Study hard. Stay away from the wrong crowd. You know, don't do drugs. Simple stuff, because I tell a kid they don't understand you're doing drugs and be with the wrong crowd. You're going to get busted. You wreck it. You can't get a job. You can't get an apartment. You know, all the stuff because you thought you was being cool.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Elie Seckbach.